Welcome everyone to ABA Live Radio. This is your host, Jacqueline Jacks, with the music reviews on the latest trends in music today. I'm so excited to be here with you because I was just looking through my browser here and I realized that there's a new Taylor Swift song that I actually have not even looked at, and it's time I did. Why? Because it's getting 79,000 views an hour. That's why. It's crazy. It's actually beating the I Made the World's Largest Pizza video. If you think it is, I don't know. Well, anyway, Lavender Haze is a video that I have heard things about, but as it just got released a day ago, it's time to actually watch the video and review it. Check out her voice. Check out what people are saying about it. And all of that great stuff in between. So I'm going to pull it up here. Of course, there's an advertisement that we'll just skip that. Before we get into the video, though, I do want to look and see what they're saying about this video, because Taylor Swift fans are so dedicated. They are the best fans I have ever heard of in my entire life. And it's pretty amazing the way they step up for this woman. I don't even know how she gets to do it other than she just gives them such a good time at these concerts. It's amazing. It's like a whole experience. Doesn't matter if you are sad, happy, depressed, Taylor Swift will always have a song for you, Sonya's Way. Very true. Yes, you are right about that. Without a doubt, the prettiest music video I've ever seen. She nailed everything, huh? Freaking queen, 6 million streams in just 24 hours. Yeah, well, that's Taylor Swift for sure. What is it about Taylor Swift that just is so addicting and enigmatic, right? I really think it's not only her attitude, but the way she was originally introduced to us, but so much more. I think that there's so much going on with this woman, you know, who was a young lady when I first saw her, performing to, what is it, with Tim McGraw. and now she's a woman and she's really stuck to her guns all the way through. You know, she's told the stories that everybody, the stories of life and being a girl growing into a woman, you know, she's told all those crazy stories that we all have gone through. And she's very relatable in that way, as well as she really has a good sense of self and always had. She's had a really great sense of humor about herself and about life. And I think that that makes her extremely relatable to people. And a lot of people at every age jump on board with that for sure. But there's so much else going on behind it. Let's go ahead and look at her beautiful new video. I can't wait to see it. And by all means, you guys are the fans. You know way more about Taylor Swift than I do. I review like 230 artists a day. So literally, I can't focus that much on every artist, but at the same time, I have the things that I hear that I love, and I always do get a real kick out of her music, and I enjoy listening to it for sure. So listen to this one. Can I just say, if you watched my previous review of the Miley Cyrus video Flowers and what's going on with Bad Bunny and what's coming up in the music festivals this year, and you're reading my newsletter over at jacquelinejacks.medium.com, I'm a music writer for Medium, and I'm one of their top music writers these days in 2023. And I do a lot of predictions of the music industry and reviews of these things. And I feel like there's so much going on in pop music right now. If you listen to Miley Cyrus and what's happening with her new song just blowing up, Right? It does show you definitely what's been going on in music, in pop music, and what we are going to see forward. There's also a new song out ahead of Pink's new album that I just did a review on too. And that definitely shows this motion of women empowerment, of breakup songs, of things, you know, past and moving on to the future and finding a really stronger sense of self. And I feel like this motion and this movement is something that we all need, whether you're male, female, whatever, you definitely need it because we're all going through it. So the messages are cohesive in that way among the pop stars today. And I feel like even in the indie music, I mean, reviewing 263 songs a day usually will give me a good overview of what's happening in music. And I feel like in the pop music, there's a lot of dance beats coming on. Like even this song, as low tempo as it is, it's got that beat, that dance beat. If you lined up Miley Cyrus's song, Pink's new song, and Taylor Swift's new song, you could pretty much have a nice dance set there and get a DJ to spin them all together. I mean, they'll work. And they all have this new nostalgic kind of flavor coming in, right? Like almost a nod to some of the disco beats that we used to hear all the time, which we saw come out in Weeknd's new album. So there is a flow, there's an ebb and flow and like an undercurrent happening in pop music right now. But let's not forget that as of festival season, we're going to see a lot of Latin again. And it's going to be very danceable and very exciting. So let's keep that in mind too. But it kind of like a puzzle, kind of all fits together. She looks fantastic, doesn't she? She looks fantastic. She's really growing up so well. That's a great vision. You know, this song does check all the boxes, right? It's got that really, really cool flow. I mean, you just feel cooler for listening to it. It's got that nice undercurrent beat that just gets you moving and keeps it going. And then she's got a beautiful video on top of it. The visuals are wonderful. Really, really well done. I don't know who produced the video. I haven't looked, but absolutely gorgeous scenes with that lavender filter that goes through it. Her voice sounds wonderful. A little bit of effect on the voice for sure. And like common things that we all know about Taylor Swift's songs, right? Like there's these beautiful, like self-sung choruses that go along with it that enhance the music and definitely bring that like more ethereal kind of sound to the song that I really like. And kind of, I'm trying to think if I've always kind of heard that through Taylor Swift, but maybe just in more recent days, this is a more modern version of Taylor Swift. But certainly this woman has grown up and she is just a full force to be reckoned with. She's just doing so well. And I love the way she reflects herself, her emotions, and explains them in the songs. I think she's done that really well here too. Thank you. She's in a fishbowl. Knocking the walls off. Opening the door to the universe. So right now in the video, for those of you following along without video and on the podcast, she's basically, she opens the windows and she sees like she's in a fishbowl. There's fish floating around in like this universe. And then she pushes the walls down and it just becomes an expansive open galaxy, you know, of almost like a freedom with fish floating around and things being in like a dreamlike state with clouds and fluffy, you know, lavender effects. And I really do think that maybe she's talking a little bit about things that she wants for her life, things that she expects for her life versus what is expected of her. And maybe just in, not just in general and specifically in this one relationship, but in everything that she does. Because I know in some of the references in the song, I noticed in the lyrics that she was referring to things and pressures from her daily life, things and pressures outside of just relationships. But she's tied it into the relationship as a theme, which is a really good way to explain it. But as you know, if you followed her life, she does have a lot of struggles and a lot of challenges every single day. Just being in this business is a challenge. It really is. So I think she's done it really well here, though. I like. Beautiful song. She just wants to stay in the lavender haze. So maybe this song is about embracing a relationship because of the really nice lavender haze you feel when you're in that great, peaceful place of getting to know someone and just, you know, loving them and feeling the love from them. And it's kind of a nice break and change from her daily grind, her struggles and her challenges. But at the same time, the fact that everybody wants her in the 1950s, you know, to get married and settle down and do the whole thing. Maybe that's the reference that she's trying to cater to here. I'm not really sure. And you, as a Taylor Swift fan, would know a lot more about that than me. So why don't you tell me what you think of the video and let me know if I was right on about anything. I am open to critiques and words of wisdoms for sure. I really enjoyed the video though. I like it and I love the song. I'm going to add it to my curator's playlist. If you would follow my curator's playlist below on Spotify, I would really, really love to see that. I try to post these kind of songs and support them as well as indie music too that I've discovered and found along the way. So that is, linked up in the description box. All right, guys, that's another music review all finished and sewn up. I was happy I saw this one. I'm really glad. I'm going to go look through YouTube and just see, one, your comments and see what other videos you want me to review, but also what is getting like 100,000 views an hour, because this is just craziness. All right, Jacqueline Jax for AVA Live Radio. Don't forget to sign up for my newsletter. I was just told that I am the number one music writer on Medium. So excited about that. Woo! Bye, guys. I'll see you later.